Brewing Book came about a little over 6 years ago now. I grew up in Kansas City, but I was in Los Angeles working on films. And a partner that I produced several films with, he knew of my sort of interest in and passion for the craft beer industry. And so he and I started talking about something that was not a film, but was craft beer related. And I had never actually worked in the industry before. But, you know, if somebody asks you if you might want to start a brewery, you know, I think the laws of the universe require you to say yes to that question. So I said, absolutely. Then I brought in our co-owner, brewmaster Travis, right away.
I was finishing law school in Chicago at the time. I'd been a home brewer for nearly a decade at that point. Rafi had the foresight to call me, say, what do you think? What if we pitched a brewery, bring it home to Kansas City, and see if we can make this thing work? I got that phone call from Rafi one day apart from getting a phone call from a law firm in Chicago that I really wanted to work at, getting a job offer. And so I was immediately presented with a pretty amazing fork in the road. And 6 years later, here I am.
For both of us, it was a change of geography, of career, of life, of everything. At the same time, it just kind of felt like in some way we were gravitating towards it. But the opportunity being there just felt like something we couldn't pass up.
This is a particularly unique time in craft beer, and it seemed like the right time in Kansas City to do this. So if I was ever going to do it, now was the time. Well, when we decided to start the brewery in Kansas City, we'd spent some time abroad, sort of learned what other beer cultures were like, and we wanted to bring some of that experience back home.
To our label, the beers are kind of informed by this approach that balances experimentation with approachability. We want to do something that kind of challenges and is a little bit different than what people might have seen or tasted before, but we don't want to reinvent the wheel, and we want to make it welcoming at the same time. So I think that's kind of what drives a lot of what we do.
So beer is made from four basic ingredients. You have malted barley, water, hops, and yeast. We're no different. We use a little wheat, oats, and rye sometimes, but basically it all starts with the grain. Wort is essentially sugar water. It's the liquid that comes off the grain once all of the starch in the grain has been converted into sugar. We mash that grain in hot water to convert the starch into sugar. We move that liquid into a kettle and boil it. We add the hops. We'll transfer that into a fermenter, pitch some yeast, and let the yeast do all the work. The common saying is that brewers make wort, a yeast makes beer. Beers typically ferment for a week or two before they're ready to transfer into packaging. And at that point, we go to what's called a bright tank. We carb that beer up, and then we get ready to keg it or can it. At Torn Label, we make a little bit of everything, but we certainly focus a lot on hop-forward beers.
We have all this range of influences as beer drinkers, and we kind of like to filter all those and kind of infuse them into this kind of a Kansas City Midwestern ethos. There is a procedural level of beer, but at the same time, you never want to lose track of what makes it expressionistic and creative.
The hops are just one of the most amazing ingredients in beer simply because they can present in so many different ways. People are familiar with hops in the sense of bitterness, and while it's true, it's not the only thing they can do. But a lot of times people enjoy some of the flavors that come from adding hops towards the end of the process. That can range if you're using German hops, which might be incredibly floral. Many of the Pacific Northwest varietals can have lots of citrus flavor. Some of the newer hops that have been developed have really strong tropical fruit, passion fruit, pineapple, and playing with those different ingredients in different ratios and in different parts of the process, you can create a really wide range of bright, inviting beers. We ended up in the East Crossroads after quite a bit of searching. We knew that the Crossroads would be a good location because of the creative energy that existed already. And we thought that sort of the artistry and the craftsmanship of beer would be a really good fit for that.
Really, one of the most important things is, you know, not just about the flavor of the beer, but how it brings people together. We want it to be a connection point, you know, both with the brewery itself and for the people here. You know, certain beers just feel more sociable. Certain beers kind of feel like, you know, they kind of spur conversation, they spur connection.
I really think that the way I look at beer and the way that we try and come up with recipes is sort of start from the end, figure out what we want to drink, what it is we're trying to put in our mouths, and then work backwards and find out how to make that happen. And I think that that really is what ties our beers together. People who love beer sitting down together, talking about what they want to drink, and then figuring out how to make it happen.